Okay, we got a straight crosswind basically coming right across the road. That makes it entertaining. So I could skip the road altogether and just launch right through the weeds. It's a flat top after all. That is the nice thing of having such a super tough cage. You can just blast right through the weeds. And that air trike is tough. Even though it's the lightest trike in the market, it is very tough and durable for launching over fairly rutted field. Okay, we got the trusty Dominator, of course. Today we've gone with a small, mainly because I'm kind of breaking in an engine, so I'm taking it a little easy. Normally I would fly something a little smaller than the small, but totally depends on what you want to do. Basically, trims all the way out for launch, always, always. So there is the true wind direction. Interesting. Which is that way. So completely cross. Let's see. Again, this is another cool reason to have a Dominator. Get some power. So you want to do your motor run up right before a launch. Now with foot launching, you walk back up to your lines and you put slack in the lines so you can accelerate your body before you have to hit the glider. But with a trike, you tension the line so you don't actually do that. So you bring it forward and you tension the lines. Thinking I'll probably pull it up and turn right. Use some hill here. See if I can't catch a little bit of wind. Let's do it. Now that I'm up, now I can pull my trims down. Bingo. All set. A little turbulent, as I would figure. But it's a freaking Dominator. Who gives a crap? Okay, we are up and flying. Let's go play. One of the funnest things on the air trike is doing touch and goes. I don't know what it is. It's like you think it's the flying that's the fun, but actually it's the landing and taking off that's like the coolest thing ever. Come in. Remember, I got a total crosswind. Set down that left wheel. Boom. Keep the glider pointing into the wind, but tilted a little the direction I'm going. And boom, here we go. Brake, off we go. Way shift left as you leave the ground. Go. Let's do it again. Diver in. Fly to zero altitude. Nice gentle touchdown. Boom. Off we go. Into the wild blue yonder. Ooh, yeah. That is so fun. You gotta get you one of these. This is seriously the coolest thing ever. I mean, just buzzing across the weeds is just freaking awesome. There's just nothing like it. Yeah, landing uphill. Ninja power, you got climb rate to out-climb the hill, of course. Set down the left tire, right tire. Ooh, yeah. Keep the glider loaded above me. And throttle. accelerate. Hands up, brake. Off we go. Oh, yeah. It's just seriously fun. I don't care who you are. It just never gets old. I've been doing it forever, and it just never gets old. It's just freaking the funnest thing ever. Set down the left tire here. Woo! Off we go. The flat top weight shifts so well, you can lean left to put down the left tire, or just lean right to put down the right tire first. You can just very easily select which tire you want to touch first, depending on which side's high or which direction you're going, to create a little more drag on that side and roll it into a turn or whatever you want to do. You have incredible control with the weight shift kit. Even on the Air Trike, doesn't change the weight shift kit. It still works perfectly as it was designed with or without the Air Trike attached. Very, very cool. Playground. Set her down. Oh yeah. That's just so fun. Just come in and land anywhere. Dominator, baby. Let's do it again, Okay, I'm gonna dive into a left-hand turn here into a landing. Itch my nose. And how about a power off landing? There you go, no motor. So you can do the same thing without throttle. I usually use throttle just because you got it, but as you can see, you can land perfectly without it. Take back off, accelerate, add little brakes. Now for a throttle on landing, let's land our right tire because we're going to go around a right turn here. Boom, set her down. Ooh yeah, lean left as we come off to turn left. The weight shift, I just hug that left side, boom. That puts the weight of my body on the left side and I turn left. And I roll the whole paramotor left. That's called weight shift. Most units are so narrow, you really can't shift your body inside of their comfort bars. But with the flat top weight shift kit, it's 22 inches wide. You got all kinds. You can see all that distance there next to my side. I got tons of room to shift my body weight. Works incredibly well. Flat top, baby! It's so fun! All right. So to land a trike, The difference is you don't have to slow down with a trike. Rip, motor off, left foot, right tire, not foot. There we go. So that was another motor off, no motor. Just dive it in, boom, touch the left tire, use that to turn into that left turn. Here we go. Accelerate off the ground. And here we go. Now, normally when you come in, you just fly to about a foot or so off the ground, then you ease off the throttle and add into brakes. because you don't need to slow down a trike. You can land at full speed because the wheels don't care how fast they roll. So all you're pulling brakes for is to control your descent rate. So you make a nice light touchdown, where when you're foot launching, you have to land as slow as you possibly can because you can only physically run so fast. So it's a very different technique with the foot launching because you have to pull every single last inch of brake to be able to slow down as much as possible. Again, that's another great place where that Dominator really comes into play, because the Dominator will simply fly slower than other gliders. Not only is it faster at the top end, but it's also slower at the bottom end to make it easier for launch and landing. And it produces more lift at a lower speed because of the lower aspect ratio. All right. That's just fun. I don't care who you are. I mean, I think just taking off and landing is like one of the funnest things ever. Just burning in, you know, one tire into that landing. There we go. Bingo. Woo-hoo! Fly it to the ground. And close to the ground, you pull brakes at the speed it takes to stop coming down. And set down. There you go. So you add brakes slowly at first, and then the more you pull brakes, the faster you pull them. Because the slower you go, the less responsive it is. Ooh, yeah. Now, there's videos out there telling you, how do you launch a trike? And they're all full of crap. How you launch a trike is you don't learn to launch a trike. You come through super training, and you absolutely master control of the paraglider. Because this is all about glider control. It is not about, oh, you just do this at that time. No, it is not mechanical. I am making infinite changes, 4 to 5 corrections per second, all these tiny little corrections. It is absolutely critical that you master glider control. Otherwise, it is just a total nightmare of carnage, and you are trashing your gear left and right. Okay, here we go. Throttle off. Woo-hoo! Diving around the corner. Coming in over the weeds. I'm leaning left. And now I lean back into the center. Brake, 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 brake. Set down lightly. There we go. Hold the little brakes. Now I'm slowly getting my hands up. I'm going to add throttle. Start putting my hands up. Add throttle. Start putting my hands up. Add throttle. Except for it's not a specific, oh, gee, your hands go up. I'm changing. Look at my hand. I mean, I'm making all these little corrections per second, keeping the glider not only perfectly loaded, but absolutely perfectly above me. If it drops even the slightest, just a couple inches to the side, it's going to want to pull you sideways off that road. So, no, it's not like, oh, look how easy it is. Buy this, and you can learn to do this in 2 days. Total flat-out lie. It takes about 25 to 60 hours of just practicing with the glider on the ground. That's just kiting. Before you even take your first flights, then it can take hundreds of flights to really work all the details out. So it is not simply pull the glider up, add brakes, full throttle. That is not how it freaking works. You have to have incredible skill with the glider first, or it's just a complete total nightmare. Okay, here we go. Diver in. Brake to control the descent. Set her down. And then as I accelerate, woohoo! Start to accelerate the glider along with the trike. Get some airspeed, ground speed. Once I'm going, about to lift off, boom. Add some brake, I pop off the ground. So dang fun! Okay, I'm gonna touch my right tire for that right turn there. Boom, just to kind of keep her balanced. Throttle, weight shift left. Right hand up, left brake, right brake, left, right, hands up, brakes. I'm making constant 4 to 5 corrections per second. So in this sport, there are so many morons out there pretending to be instructors. Like one is this guy named Kurt Pfister. Oh my gosh, he will literally take people, make them buy the gear, and pretend he's gonna train them if they buy the gear from him. And then what he calls training is stick you in the thing and tell you to hit the throttle. Yeah, here's your training. Hit the throttle. You want to hear it again? It is a freaking nightmare. And then, of course, they edit out the thousands of crashes, the total carnage and death, and just pretend that, oh, yeah, that's what it was. That's how easy it was. Liars and scammers, man. You got to look for skills. Let's see anybody else do this. Come in sideways, land it, no motor. Bring it. Let's see that sideways landing. One wheel, every time, over and over, unedited. I mean, if you got the skills, you got the skills. Shouldn't be rocket science. Okay, off throttle. Little bit of throttle to roll out that round out. Touch the right tire first, left tire. Bring it around that corner, full throttle, accelerate, little left turn, and head down the road. Just in case my motor dies, I can land on a road. See, if the motor died, I could go, whoop, hit that road, boop, there's a tire. So you're always thinking about what you're gonna do if that motor dies. At every second of every flight, where am I gonna land? Like over here, I could land uphill. Uphill's kind of nice because it'll slow you down very quickly, so you won't have a very long roll. In case you're in rough ground, it'd be nice to come to a quick stop. So landing uphill can help you do that. All right, let's do this landing again. Because it's fun. I don't care if I've done it 10 million times. It's just dang fun. There we go. Oh, let's pretend we got a motor out. And okay, here we go. Woo! And bring her in. And balloon flare, break. Touch her down. Boing. And throttle. Woohoo! Accelerate, brake, pop off cleanly. Okay, set down the right tire. Whoop, right tire pulls me around that turn. See how that pulled my front nose to the right? Because I set down that right tire first. And so if I'm landing on a right turn, I'm going to set down that right tire first. Ooh, yeah. And yes, I could land there. It's just a little rough. It's so fun! You got to try this. You got to come through super training. Don't even try and think that you're just going to jump in one of these and go fly it. It's just retarded. It's total, just a complete nightmare. This is 100 times harder than I make it look. Keep in mind, I'm the best pilot in the world, so obviously I'm going to make it look very easy at my skill level. To teach someone else to do this takes an incredible amount of time. It's a 10, 11 day trip. And you're literally practicing upwards of 7, 8, even 9, 10 hours a day, every day. It's just massive amount of hours, as much as you can physically deal with in that time. And not everybody passes. That's a good question to ask around if you're trying to compare instructors. Not that anybody compares, but a trick question is ask them how often people don't pass their class. And a lot of them will say, oh no, yeah, I guarantee I'll get you in the air. So right there, they're admitting that they don't give one crap about your safety. If you're horribly uncoordinated and 90 years old and can't barely move, they're gonna chuck you in the air because they really don't give a crap if you die. At Super Training, we're only gonna put you in the air if you first master a solid level of glider control. Booyah, that's so fun. So master the skills first, then do the flying. Because it's not fun to be scared to death. That's not fun. You don't want to scare the crap out of yourself and feel like you're going to die. You want to be confident and have the skills and experience to really have that feel and know that you have control and know that you know what you're doing and have not just the skill, but have it built into reflexes where it's just automatic. That's what makes it fun. That's what makes you a good, safe pilot. Yee-hoo-hoo! So fun. I just love that. Booyah. Touchdown, takeoff. Do it again. So the wind's a little to the left. Nova Sound crabbing left. So the wind is actually still a little cross, still coming from the left there. But no biggie, doesn't matter as long as you got the skills to maintain control of the glider. Left tire. And use that left tire to turn it in. And of course, the front wheel on the Air Trike caster, so it's, I'm not really steering it much, it's just automatically tracking with the glider. Go, going right a little bit, bringing in a little right tire. Boom. So fun! I don't know how many flights that was, but that was a whole bunch. Just for fun! There we go, downwind. Downwind crosswind. And of course the Air Trike automatically stabilizes. If you notice I hit a little sideways, doesn't matter, it just automatically tracks like a shopping cart because of that castered front landing gear. Just automatically wants to track the direction you're going even if you land butt wild sideways. Driving up the road. Driving along in my automobile. So fun. Throttle. Ninja power. Off we go. Let's land it. Fly to just off the ground. Ease off throttle. Go into brakes. Boop. Touch her down. Trike tracks into the direction we're going. Landing going uphill as you notice. I'm gonna drop the glider over to the side. Erk. Bingo. Kerboom. Catabatic flow. The wind's coming down the hill.